Hey, and welcome to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove radio show on TV. Is it radio show, TV, radio?
It could be either.
I'm kind of flummoxed, Tim.
You could turn the picture off and it could be radio.
Or turn around and just listen to our dulcet tones.
Our dulcet, harmonious tones.
The sort of voices that make you weak at the knees, yeah?
It makes me weak at the knees.
Yes, I know. We've got an interesting show for you, which I'm going to go straight on to talk about because I'm embarrassed about the last thing I said.
Okay.
Which we're not going to dwell on.
No, we won't dwell
on. To tell you that in the second half of this show, we have Hold Me Tight.
Ooh.
So you have to stay for that. And actually, whilst you're waiting for them to come on, we really have something good for you, which is the opportunity to hear about adult play. Yeah?
Ooh.
Yeah, is that kind of fun?
Yes, I'm into this.
Yes.
Let's do it.
Right. In which case, it is a sheer, absolute, unalloyed joy to have Simon Summer join us. And he is from Happy Brighton. Simon.
Hello.
Welcome.
Hi.
It's a joy to have you on
how's
the show.
How's your dulcet voice?
It is. I was going to start like that, but I thought I'd better address the adult play issue before
10 minutes of doing
before
silly
my children
voices.
Are wondering what on earth I'm actually up to.
Yes. Daddy is on the TV.
With some strange men.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Talking about play for adults.
Yeah.
I'm really sorry. I don't know where I've gone with this. Hello, Simon. Would you like to tell us why you're really here?
Yes. Well, it's to do with adult play, but not the kind of adult play that people might be thinking. It's
what?
Like Andy.
It's what?
It's
what?
Okay. It's about getting people. Adults, but children too. I do it for children as well.
Yes.
Getting people together in groups, getting them playing together, trying to connect, have fun.
Mm-hmm.
The games are. There's three aims. I mean, one is to just have fun, and there's lots of silly games like we will blindfold everybody and they're all a secret animal and they've got to wander around. You know, if you're a cow and you're a cow, you've got to moo until they find the rest. So silly games like that, like party games that you would play. But exactly. Were you there at that event? I do remember a rather odd sounding cow at that particular event.
That was a llama. Anyway.
It was a llama. Okay. Yes. Okay.
Yeah. Andy Chen, animal impersonator.
Hardly.
Listen,
we're here for Simon.
Sorry, Simon.
No, not about you, Simon.
No. Some of them are very, very silly and just a lot of fun.
Yes.
But we're also trying to get people communicating in different ways. There's a lot of kind of eye contact games, trying to encourage people to have eye contact, because it's something that we're all, especially in Western civilization, we're kind of uncomfortable with eye contact. Yeah. And we... Yeah, why? You know, we're around for a while and we don't like looking at each other.
Yeah.
You know, I see you two have this issue.
we often do. I'm looking
everyone
this way.
Does.
Wait till you meet Debs.
On the plus side, everybody does have that. I'm trying to encourage people to, you know, to get past that a little bit and, put them into situations where we encourage eye contact. Hopefully they still feel safe. We try and take precautions with that. And also there are sort of other games... just trying to get them to view each other differently, which I know sounds a little wishy-washy, but you'll have to come and play the games if you want to.
People who come and play these games, do they have any sort of... How do I put this nicely? Do they have any sort of conditions that they need to... release?
No.
Does that make sense? Are they
not really?
Stressed? Sorry.
Is it therapeutic?
I mean,
you know.
Made sense in my head.
The last event I did for a charity group, a wonderful charity called Action for Happiness.
Oh yeah, we like them.
Lovely people, and they attract people who come along wanting to find different ways to be happy.
Mm.
So that for Brighton Happy is a very easy thing. People come along wanting to be happy. With open hearts,
it's
open
like
minds.
A match made on earth.
It is,
yeah.
And it becomes very easy for me because people are. But I kind of also want to take it and do take it to businesses as well,
right.
Because my own. I only have one experience of working in an office about 20 years ago. It was only for about a year, and it was one of the most frightening experiences of my life. The way you're sat there next to somebody for 8 hours a day, and Ossif Gossip.
You're perfect for this show, by the way.
Office gossip.
Well done.
Little office politics, things like that. And people sitting in their own little world and just
it's
kind of
communication
trying
thing,
to get
it?
Them to yeah. view each other in a different way and just have a happier life. And that's the passion behind it. I think we're
that's
all
the place I want to work.
Right.
Yeah, the one that's happy.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Yes. And I think we're all you know, generally it's not just work. That's one particular situation, but I really passionately believe we're all capable of living so much happier lives, not in that kind of, you know, wishy-washy, airy-fairy way, but a contented way.
Deep authentic.
You know, and there's so many things taking away from that. But
by connecting with other people, you get
negative media.
In some respects.
Yeah, playing, connecting in a different way. Hmm. Getting come together now. You be a cow, I'll be a sheep, and we will crawl
we'll
around
that.
On our hands and knees. adult play.
if there's a local business out there that's hearing you right now, what is the impact to their baseline for having their staff happier? What's the why should they hire? Why should they bring you in? I mean, we want you because you're great fun, clearly. Yeah. But you know, why should they?
Well, well-being is a very current important thing in the office, and a lot of businesses these days have to comply with well-being criteria in their.
So there's a duty of care.
Yes, there's a duty of care, and that's very much what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to give them. That sense of well-being through play.
Yes.
You know, through at the end of the day, it could be very loosely described as team building.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Makes more sense than paintballing.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's like, why are you shooting each other?
Yes.
How's it building a team?
Yes. There's no paintballing involved in this. It is. It's getting people out having fun.
Yeah.
One, two, trying to get them to return to their office a little bit, you know, questioning their relationship with their colleagues. Mm. Okay, maybe that guy that, you know, that I thought was kind of rude to me is actually quite a nice guy. You know,
makes kinda, a good llama.
Yeah,
it's good llama impersonation.
It's trying to create a happier. yes.
I've learned something about Andy I didn't know before. This is great.
Well, at the very least, you know, give them something to gossip more about. No, but it's trying to improve their well-being and the culture, you know, the office. And Brighton's a great place for it.
It's better than an office party where everybody gets drunk.
How's the business going? How's it coming together? Is there a receptiveness to this playfulness?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. And especially, I think, Brighton. You know, it's the best place on earth. I lived abroad for 20 years. I'm from Cornwall originally, which is...
It's quite nice in
also
Cornwall.
Also the best place on earth.
It's quite nice.
It is.
Yeah.
It's very, very nice. I was 20 years abroad. I came to Brighton thinking it was a stepping stone to go back to Cornwall.
Yeah. And you never made the step.
No, didn't want to. Just found such a wonderful place and the openness of the people here and the tolerance. I mean, it's famous. It's well known for that.
Yeah.
But that all lends itself perfectly to what I'm trying to do and achieve.
John, I have to ask the business question. What's the game plan for the business? How's it opening up? What are you... How are you kind of making this business sort of work?
Yeah, I'm not too worried about the... You know, I'm quite lucky that I have enough, you know, business to keep me ticking over. I've never been that materialistic. My main aim is to try and this is going to sound silly when I watch it back, but it's to make people happy. It's to try and contribute in a positive way, and I think that
you're bright and happy. If it didn't make people happy,
well, I think that helps to your own well-being as well.
Exactly,
if you can actually, you know, people actually do genuinely feel better if they're
happy. Just for you, this is so good. I'm really glad that you're doing the opposite to us.
We studied Brighton and Hove, it didn't go well.
Right, but I invite you both to an event. So
I think we need to come to one of your events.
So. You're hereby invited.
Are there public events? Is this what you're saying? Can we plug them? Would you like to plug them?
No, at the moment I'm doing it on a sort of ad hoc case-by-case basis. I am looking to also do it in the evenings. I'm a parent, so that was something that I wanted to avoid, but my children are growing up now, so I'm looking at doing it more on a kind of drop-in basis as well. But I've got nothing to plug. I'm quite happy and going out there.
Very
if anybody sees this,
anyway.
If anyone sees this, please come and talk to me. Yeah. But I'd be
what
more than happy
we'll get,
to.
We'll get a link to your website up, which is interesting. I really like the sentence on it that says "fun is happy." Sorry, fun is important.
Yes,
that's such a brilliant sentence.
Yeah.
Right. Well, something I found out when I was, you know, a couple of years ago setting up the website is I went into a quote book and there's just about every famous philosopher that ever lived. All have said something, a quote about play, about the importance of play, the importance of the child within the adult that we need to kind of focus more on.
Yeah. Really interesting.
It is.
We've got one more minute.
Is there an important message to share with the citizens of our wonderful republic about happiness, play, Brighton?
Yes, I would say once you've watched this programme, switch off your screens, go for a walk, breathe, ignore the media for a week.
Good, yes.
I probably shouldn't be saying this on a television programme, but get out of your head and into the world and play.
And play more.
That's brilliant. Brilliant sentiment.
Simon, thank you very much. It's really great to chat with you.
You're welcome.
You've got to tune in. You've got to stay with us after these messages because we have Hold Me Tight, and we're not even going to describe who they are. I'm just going to tease them. In the meanwhile, some animal noises.
Quack, quack. Is that a cat? Welcome back to the second half of the People's Republic Brighton and Hove, TV / radio / performance art, who knows.
What more could you want?
Andy and Simon have run off together to make a farmyard together. It's rather beautiful.
Yeah,
but dance, we can join them later if you like.
I'll think about that.
We could be the farmer and, you know. Anyway, let's move away from this. Who's on the second half?
We have joining us, we're very lucky to have joining us, Sandy and Richard from Hold Me Tight UK. Thank you both so much for joining us and coming to speak to us. So, Hold Me Tight UK. What a lovely name.
What does it mean?
What is it?
So, please tell us what it's all about.
Well, it's relationship workshops, mm-hmm. so for couples, and it's based on the work of Dr. Sue Johnson. Mm-hmm. And it's basically a relationship education mm-hmm. and enhancement workshop.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, having had a quick look at Dr. Sue on Twitter, I like Dr. Sue's as well, but having had a look at Dr. Sue on
relationships,
might do.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
I have had a quick look at her Twitter profile, and so she's an author, she's a relationship expert, and you
book.
Bang.
It's a book.
So that is a
book. Remember that, folks? This books.
So the workshops that you provide are based on her findings, her teachings, her research, her approach. Is that correct?
Yes. I'll speak to this. So in this book, Hold Me Tight, Dr. Sue Johnson talks about a new science of love. She describes that love's really an emotional bond. Mm-hmm. And in this workshop, we help couples to understand how that bond works and how you can create a secure, loving relationship. Mm-hmm. And then she goes on to describe 7 key conversations that couples can have in the workshop we're providing to help them become closer.
So do you work with couples in crisis or do you work with couples at any stage of their relationship? What's your target audience?
It's a whole lot. So we have couples who basically happy, mm-hmm. but want to just take their relationship a little bit further.
Mm-hmm. Happier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, happier.
Yeah.
And we have couples who are maybe just hitting a bit of a rocky patch.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And we also have couples who are struggling quite a bit. Mm-hmm. They may need more, but this can give them a starting point.
It's a good starter,
And really also, what we find really great for a lot of couples is they would find it a bit much to go, say, to couples counselling. Mm-hmm. But this is educational workshop, mm-hmm. but it's also with other couples.
Yes.
And you get the sort of feeling, oh, yeah, this is normal. Mm-hmm. This is what mm-hmm. couples go through. Mm-hmm. This is what it's like. Mm-hmm. And we can learn together. Mm-hmm. And one of the unique things that we offer is in the workshops, we do an educational piece, and then these 7 conversations that Sue Johnson's kind of outlined mm-hmm. based on her award-winning EFT mm-hmm. approach.
What does EFT stand for?
Emotionally focused couples therapy. It's missing the C bit.
Yeah, that's quite good. Okay.
But we give the space for couples to have those conversations mm-hmm. together. We give them a sort of lead into it, and then we guide them. Mm-hmm. But they have a private time to have those conversations and get started in a way that they might not feel comfortable or safe enough to do just on their own.
What's the difference between that and relate, then? Is it?
Ah.
Ah.
Well, well,
he's done it now. I'll step back now. I'll step back later.
They're related to separate couples counselling organisations.
That's what's going through my head. I was thinking, what is different?
Because this is group work. Yes. What you're providing is different in that respect. Yes. It's not.
Yeah. I'd say our strengths is we're really looking at the emotional bond that couples have. And how to be able to talk about the feelings underneath. So we support couples. We come round and when they're having these conversations, we come round. We support them in looking at how arguments are actually like a sort of a pattern of interactions. So we help slow that down.
More kind of informal than a relate interview? Is it more sort of, I don't know how to put this, is it more tactile? I don't know. I'm trying to think what it is.
Okay. Yes. So, in relate, it would just be your couple with a counsellor. Whereas what we're doing is we've got a lot of couples in a large space.
Right.
We've got videos up for them to, you know, Sue Johnson talking, other couples doing this kind of work.
So it's like a group activity with loads of couples.
It's an odd combination of it is a group activity,
but
when it's the actual conversations themselves, the couples are doing those privately.
Yeah.
Just together with each other, and they don't sort of share it unless they want to.
Unless they want to, which is
This, I have a kind of youth work background, and this reminds me of the Break for Change programme, which is with, it's for when there's been parent and child issues, and that's a group work programme for parents and children. And the thing that I always really liked about their approach was it's a no blame approach. And is that similar? Is Hold Me Tight a similar approach? So removing, because it's very easy when you're in the relationship, be that parent, child, couple relationship, friendship even, when there's conflict, when there's difficulties, go, well, you did this, you did that, you're to blame for this, you're to blame for that. But the sense I'm getting from what you provide is that that's just not even raised. Yeah. Who's done what wrong? It's about moving forward.
Yeah. And it's also about getting underneath.
Yes.
So, if you end up in your couple dynamic in that sort of fight, it's your fault, it's your fault.
Who's the bad
guy? We help them, who's the bad guy is the way that we kind of describe that pattern. We're like going underneath what we found through attachment work. This is such an interesting thing. I found it very exciting, the science of adult attachment is... that we need to feel safe with our partner, and when we don't feel emotionally safe, then we tend to react with our old patterns.
Yeah. It's ringing bells,
I can see. So this helps us slow down enough that we can pay attention to the early signals and get to understand our raw spots and our partner's raw spots and just be able to take a different position. It's more... passionate and connected.
That's alongside each other, not against each other.
Yes, and when we identify that pattern, a couple can be able to talk about what goes on and sort of like step slightly back from it so they're not in it. And then they can see, actually, rather than each other being the enemy, the pattern's the enemy.
The pattern's
So that's, so that's really sort good. Of a clever sort of reframe of what's going on. When you can talk about what's going on, you use more space to be able to do something about it.
From what I can gather, every couple needs this. Because what you're providing is essentially an approach where a couple can understand each other, move forward, have better communication. What's the success rate? Like, if people come back to you and said, well, we were on the brink of divorce and now we're staying together. Have you had those? Oh, amazing. So it really does.
It's
really
not 100% guaranteed.
Well, of course, nothing is. But you've had a good, decent hit rate.
It might be also good that they have split up.
But also, couples on the verge of splitting up, feeling like they've got a starting point to reconnect. You know, they've found a way that they can start to talk about things. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. We also look at relationship strengths. Mm. Yeah.
We've got a few minutes left. What everyone's going to want to know is, how can they get in contact with you? How can they sign up, find out more about you? What's the route into this?
Postcard. We're very old school here.
It's a postcard from Brighton.
Yay,
it's Brighton.
So if I could just have a read of that, just in case. So Relationship workshops, so they will be running in Brighton on the 8th and 9th of June, which is a Saturday and a Sunday, and again on a Saturday and Sunday, the 14th and 15th of September. And it's very simple, www.holdmetight.co.uk. And we will share all of the details of your events, of your website, and how to get in contact with you. They've probably been flashing up as we've been speaking for that wizardry.
We've also got a Facebook page.
Oh, you've got a Facebook page?
Yay! Yeah.
Nobody has one of them.
Is it just
Hold Me Tight UK?
Hold Me Tight UK on Facebook. Fantastic. So you've got the 2 weekends coming up. Mm-hmm. How long have you been going for? Is this a relatively new thing you've been doing?
We've all been relationship counsellors. Yes. There's 4 of us, actually.
Okay. Yes.
For some time, we're all fully trained. Mm. And some of us have actually been on these workshops, assisted in them, but it's been a relatively new venture. We started up last year, didn't we?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But you've got a background in dealing with couples.
Yeah.
Yes, you're all trained.
And running workshops.
Excellent.
And, yeah.
Will you come back and see us after the June workshop and tell us how it's gone?
Sure.
We will. That'd be fun.
That'd be brilliant. We would absolutely love to see you again.
Pleasure.
As I said, we will share all of those details. It sounds great what you're doing, and you've clearly helped so many people with what you're doing. And we really encourage
you.
You
should work on the show.
Come along.
Make us all get on.
I mean, you'd really have your work cut out.
Animal.
Pleasure. Do come.
You just want to be a llama, we've got big problems.
Sandy and Richard, thank you so much. We look forward to seeing you again. Best of luck. And thank you, our viewers, for joining us. Do join us next time. Thank you and good night.